Right. Shorthand dictation, 100 words per minute, 7 minutes speed, 10 seconds. Five seconds. Now write down. Ladies and gentlemen, I have great pleasure in inaugurating the 5th annual conference of the Society for Conservation of Energy Resources here in Chennai. I am happy to note that in the short period of 5 years, our city has got the distinction of hosting the conference for the second time. The only indicates the fact that Tamil Nadu has been in the forefront of using the energy resources in an efficient manner and also in exploiting renewable sources of energy provided to us by nature. On this occasion, I would like to point out that energy is the key factor which drives the nation. Whether it is industrial production, agriculture, infrastructure, or day-to-day domestic life, we are dependent upon energy for all our activities. As we all know, man has been using natural materials to light fires and provide energy from time immemorial. But the last 200 years of human existence have led to many inventions and discoveries touching upon all walks of life. As a matter of fact, electricity has become our most essential requirement after water, not only in the urban areas but also in the rural areas. It may not be out of place to point out in this connection that even in the interior parts of our country and especially our state, we have succeeded in providing electricity to all houses except in remote hills and reserve forests. As you will appreciate, though we want all-round development and modernization, we must at the same time ensure that such development does not come at the cost of degrading our forests and other natural resources. In order to protect the environment and the forest, we are not encouraging provision of electricity and roads in remote areas situated in the reserve forest. While we are happy about providing electricity to our villages, we must not lose sight of the fact that most of our energy is now being produced from sources like crude oil and coal, which are getting depleted day by day. Our rate of energy requirement is bound to increase as our country develops, and at this rate, the natural resources like wood, petrol, and coal cannot last forever. So we have to find some other sources of energy like solar and wind energy. I would like to take this opportunity to inform you that Tamil Nadu is the leader in using wind energy in the country. Half of the country's production of wind power is from the state of Tamil Nadu. I am happy to state that we are also not far behind in using solar energy, since we have sunny days for most parts of the year. We are not able to get much energy from water without much rainfall in our state. Nuclear energy is very costly, and there is also the question of safety. Solar and wind energy are the cheapest and do not lead to pollution. With these words, I wish you all success. Thank you. Letter from Mohan Printing Works, 10 Kamarajar Salai, Shivakasi, to Messrs. Gopal and Company, Netaji Road, Tiruchi. Dear Sirs, we would like to introduce ourselves as a leading and modern printer in Tamil Nadu. We are happy to inform you that this year we are celebrating our 20th anniversary, and as part of the celebrations, we are offering attractive discounts to our customers. We undertake all kinds of printing works, including latest computerized methods of printing. We have the most modern machinery, and we will be able to undertake printing on all sizes of papers and cards used by a variety of customers. On this occasion, we are also glad to inform you that from this year, we have also started printing large size computerized color posters used in the advertisement industry. Most of the leading fireworks factories in Shivakasi are our customers. As your company is a very famous one in the whole of our state, we believe that it would be a privilege for us to undertake your printing works. We therefore wish to hear from you a convenient date on which we can depute our marketing manager to your office for further discussions. Thanking you, yours faithfully.